It's been just 1 week since Anna Hazare's protest fast against corruption ended in the capital. Within these 7 days, as many as 3 key members of Team Anna have been served breach of privilege notices for speaking out against corruption. Now, even as the row is growing over these notices, the BJP has accused the government of witch hunting against whistleblowers.
First, Kiran Bedi. Then, Prashant Bhushan. And now, Arvind Kejriwal. All slapped with breach of privilege notices. Three notices slapped in barely 48 hours. But Team Anna is undeterred, speaking out against the latest government move.
Speaking the truth or expressing your honest opinions in public interest is treated to be a breach of privilege by Parliament or by members of Parliament, then I think the time has come to re-examine as to what constitutes parliamentary privilege.
I will not apologize for speaking the truth and becoming people's a voice of an outcry.
While the Congress justified the income tax notice to Kejriwal for violation of employment norms after he accused the department of carrying out the bidding of their political bosses,
ये नोटिस आज इनके नहीं दिए गए, सन 2006 के नोटिस उनको मिले हुए हैं। जब सर्विस रूल्स के माफिक उनको 2 साल का स्टडी लीव के बाद 2 साल की सरकारी सेवा में रहना चाहिए, क्यों नहीं रहे? तब से नोटिस मिला हुआ, आज का नोटिस थोड़ी ना है।
3.5 साल के बाद मैंने रिजाइन किया तो मैंने कोई बॉन्ड कंडीशन वायलेट नहीं की है, तो ये सरकार का कहना गलत है। दूसरी चीज, सरकार बॉन्ड को शायद गलत तरीके से इंटरप्रेट कर रही है।
The BJP did not lose an opportunity to hit out at the government.
अगर वो इतने गड़बड़ आदमी थे तो उनसे 2 महीना बातचीत क्यों किया भैया? 5 मंत्रियों ने आपको मालूम है क्यों बात किया उनसे?
But some support came for Team Anna from unexpected quarters too.
Motion being slapped against Prashant, I think is completely untenable because you know we all have a right to criticize whichever structure we want.
All this on a day when even Baba Ramdev accused the government of witch hunting those trying to blow the whistle on corruption. After a short-lived lull, the battle between civil society and the government has escalated, a confrontation that is nowhere near over. Munmun Bharacharya for Times Now.
Moving on.